This is CGTN, China Global Television Network.
Turning to North Africa now, where Tunisia is set to launch the country's first satellite in March next year, in an event that will coincide with its 65th Independence Day celebrations. The satellite, which is called Challenge 1, will be launched from a base in Kazakhstan aboard the Russian Soyuz 2 rocket. It is expected to play a critical role in improving the provision of data, including climate information, that will be helpful to farmers. CGTN's Adnan Shawashi now reports.
The African space market is rapidly evolving, with Tunisia set to mark its first venture into space. The Tunisian satellite, which is known as Challenge 1, will use a new protocol, LoRa, or Long Range in Space, which is a low-power wide area network.
To the world, we want to show that Tunisia has good skills, and now we are in the club of nations who work in space and technology of space. So it's for us a big responsibility to be successful in this challenge and to launch our first Tunisian satellite with the technology of Internet of Things.
The Telnet Group general manager says he's in favor of the transfer of satellite technology to other African nations. Telnet also plans to launch a constellation of 30 satellites for African services and the Internet of Things.
As a Tunisian company, we think that we have responsibility against our continent, Africa. So as we have taken the technology from the developed country in Europe, in US, and in Russia, and in China, I think it's in our responsibility to introduce this technology to our neighbors and to our countries in Africa, which Tunisia can be the bridge.
There are many possible uses for Challenge 1, ranging from remotely activating solar pumps in the Sahara to tracking livestock crossing Tunisian borders into Algeria or Libya, and even keeping track of the climate. In a bid to share its technology expertise, Telnet Group opened a subsidiary in Saudi Arabia in collaboration with Middle East Fiber Cable Manufacturing to launch a new entity that ties Telnet Arabia. The new subsidiary now operates in space and earth telecommunications to serve the Middle East market.
Our objective is to help Saudi engineers to make alone their satellite, and we will give them our expertise, and after that our Saudi subsidiary and our Saudi implementation can do the same thing for the countries of Middle East. And in that case, we can also launch a constellation of 30 satellites for this region.
Challenge 1 was developed by Tunisian engineers and skills. It will be launched from a base in Kazakhstan aboard the Russian Soyuz 2 rocket.
Mohamed Flicha, the founder and CEO of Telnet Group, says his company has paved the way for other Tunisian and African tech companies to become satellite manufacturers. Currently, Telnet Holding has subsidiaries in France, Germany, the US, the UAE, and Saudi Arabia. Adnan Shawashi, CGTN, Tunis.